So coming to the rotations of AVL tree, we have two types of rotations for AVL tree. One is single rotation, the other one is double rotation. Single rotation that we have discussed in previous session as well. It consists of two further types of rotations. One is left rotation, the other one is right rotation. The other category of rotation is double rotations, where we perform left and right rotation both, or we can perform right and left rotation. So double rotations mein pehle hum left rotation karenge, afterwards we'll perform right rotation. But in double rotation, in other category, we will perform right rotation first and then left rotation. So we'll look out the examples based on this today. So we had discussed the examples based on left rotation, the single rotation. So we have to insert A, B and C. For that, firstly we have inserted A, and it's zero balance, it is having zero balance factor. Then we had this inserted B, and the balance factor of B will be zero and A will be one. Then we had inserted C, and the balance factor of C is 0, B is 1 and A is 2. So this is now not an AVL tree, because it is its one node is having a balance factor more than 1. So we have to perform rotation so that the nodes can attain a balanced factor. So we will be rotating towards left. We will perform left rotation, and then B will become root node, and we will recalculate the balance factor. C's balance factor is 0, A's balance factor, B's balance factor is again 0, and A's balance factor is 0. Why B's balance factor is 0? Because we have the formula: height of right subtree minus height of left subtree. So height of right subtree is 0, height of one, and height of left subtree is also 1. So 1 minus 1 is 0. Then other example that we had discussed is for right rotation under single rotation category. So we have to insert C, B and A, and then we are inserting firstly C with balance factor 0, then we have inserted B with balance factor 0, and C's balance factor will be 1 now. Why 1? Because it is not having any right subtree. So 0 minus 1. 1 is the height of left subtree. So it comes to 1. Then we have inserted A with balance factor 0, and then we will perform right rotation, because C is having balance factor 2. So we will perform right rotation, and now we again have to calculate the balance factor. So A's balance factor is 0, B's balance factor is again 0, and C's balance factor is 0. So now this tree is balanced one, and it is an AVL tree. Now moving ahead to the other category of rotations, that is left and right rotation. So let's see how we can perform left right rotation or double rotation. So let's have an example. We have to insert C, B and A. Firstly, we have inserted C, and the balance factor of C at this point is 0. Afterwards, we have inserted A, and now we have to recalculate the balance factor. So the balance factor of A is 0, C will be 1. Now we have inserted B, and we have inserted B as A's right child. So the balance factor will be recalculated, and balance factor of B will be now 0. The balance factor of A now will be 1, because it is having only right child and no left child. So it comes to 1 minus 0, which will be calculated as 1. Then afterwards, the balance factor of C will now be 2. You can calculate. Its left subtree is having height 2, whereas its right subtree having 0 height. Fine, so it comes to be 2. So now we have to balance this tree so that every node will occupy a balance factor 0, 1 or minus 1. So we have to perform certain rotations. So in this case, firstly we will perform left rotation for the node A. We will perform left rotation to the left subtree first. So we will place B as a node and A as a child. So this way we can perform left rotation first, and we will recalculate the balance factor, and then we will perform right rotation. First we will perform left rotation, then we will perform right rotation across the root node. So this will give us the tree as B will become the root node, A will become the left child, and C will become the right child. And we will recalculate the balance factor. Now the balance factor of A is 0, B's balance factor is 0, and C's balance factor is again 0. So now this tree is a balanced tree, and it termed as ABL tree. So this is how we can perform left and right rotation. So in this type of rotation, we first perform left rotations, and afterwards we will perform right rotations. So moving ahead toward the another type of rotation, that is right left rotation. Now we have to perform right rotation first in the subtree, then afterwards left rotation. So let's take the example. We have to insert A, C and B. So let's check out the example here. Firstly, we have inserted A with balance factor 0. Since it is not having any left or right child, so the balance factor is 0. Then we have to insert C, and we have inserted C as a right child. So we will recalculate the balance factor. The balance factor of C is 0, A is 1. Then we will insert B as left child of C. Now again we will recalculate the balance factor. The balance factor of B is 0, A is 1 and B is 2. Since one node is having balance factor more than 1, so this is now an imbalanced tree, and this will not be considered as ABL tree. So we have to balance this tree so that each and every node attains either 0, 1 or minus 1 balance factor and will be a ABL tree. So we will be performing rotations. We have to perform right rotation first in this case. So we will perform right rotation across C. So this way B become the node, C become the child, and afterwards we will perform left rotation towards root node. So we will perform left rotation toward root node. Then B will become the root node, C will become right child, and A will become left child. So we will recalculate the balance factor. The balance factor of C will be now 0. B will be again 0. 1 minus 1 goes to 0 and A will be 0. So this way Now this is our balance tree, which will be an AVL tree. So this is how double rotations are performed, and we have to perform either left and right rotation or right and left rotation. So let's move ahead and let's have a look to one more example. We have to construct an AVL tree by inserting 1 to 10. We are performing insertion into AVL tree. In the previous examples as well, we have inserted the nodes to formulate AVL tree, right? So we are performing insertion operation in AVL tree. So how insertion will be done? We have to create, we have to construct an AVL tree by inserting 1 to 10. So let's check out how this construction will be done. Firstly, we will be inserting 1. So our AVL tree is having only one node as if now, then afterwards we have inserted 2. So the condition of BST is what? Any node whose value is greater than the right the root node will goes to the right side. So that is why two has gone to the right side of 1, right? So it will become the right child. So we have inserted 3. Now 3 is again greater than 1, it will goes to right side. It is greater than 2, it goes to right side. So it will become the right child of 2, right? So you can check the balance factor here of 3 is 0, 2 is 1, and 1 is 2. So this AVL tree is now imbalanced, and we have to perform rotation so that it will be a balanced tree. So we will be performing left rotation, right? So we will be performing left rotation. So when we are performing left rotation, you can check here, we have performed left rotation. So 2 become the root node and 1 become the child node, left child, and 3 become the right child. So we can calculate the balance factor. 1's balance factor now is 0, 3's balance factor is 0, and 2's balance factor is again 0. So now this is a balanced tree. So we can insert more node. Moving ahead, you can check here. This way we will be performing the rotations and construct the tree. So while we are inserting the nodes, likewise we will be performing the rotations. So you can practice it, how to perform rotations, where to perform left rotation, right rotation, or left right or right left rotation. So now just tell me where 10 will be inserted. Where 10 will be inserted, you can check 10 is greater than 4, so it goes to right side. 10 is greater than 6, so it goes to right side. 10 is also greater than 8, so it will goes to right side. And 10 is greater than 9, so it will be a right child of 9, right? So we will be inserting it as right child of 9. Fine. So this will be ultimately our AVL tree. You can check. So this is how we can perform insertions in our AVL tree, and we can balance our AVL tree by using rotations, left and right rotation. So meanwhile, let's look out one more example for insertion. Afterwards, we'll be heading toward the deletion operation in AVL tree. But first, let's look for one more example for insertion operation. Let's have the example. We have to insert 64, 1, 44, 26, 13, 110, 98, and 85. So we have to insert these elements one by one and construct AVL tree, right? So let's start by inserting firstly 64. We have to insert 64 so afterwards we have to insert one. We will be scanning this way, okay, one element at a time. So 64 is inserted and its balance factor is zero. Its balance factor is zero because it is not having any right or left child as if now. Fine. So moving ahead, next we have one. One is smaller than 64, so it will be inserted in left side. So we can calculate the balance factor. Balance factor of one is zero and 64 will be one, right? So afterwards we will be inserting 44. So where 44 will go? Where 44 will go? 44 is less than 44 is less than 64 and it is greater than 1. So it goes to right side of tree of 1. Now we can recalculate the balance factor. Balance factor of 14 is 0. So the balance factor of 1 now is minus 1 and balance factor of 64 is 2, right? So now this is imbalanced and we have to perform rotation. So since we have two factors, as in this is a right child and this is left child, so we will be performing LR rotation. We will perform LR rotation. So the resulting will be I'll show you one by one. So firstly we will be rotating this toward left side. So it will be 14, 1 and 64. Or you can just be clear, when our tree is skewed toward one side, then only we will perform single rotation. But if it is balanced toward both the side, left and right, we will perform double rotation. Okay, ji? So next, we have to perform right rotation. So after that, our tree will be like 14, 1 and 64. So I think I have done this wrong. We have taken 14 by mistake. So let it be 14, okay? It will make no difference. So now you can recalculate our balance factor. So balance factor will come to 0 for all the nodes. Alright. So this way we can perform the rotations. Now we have to insert other elements. We can insert similarly 26, 13, 110 and 98. So let's make the insertions. Firstly, we have to insert 26. So 26 is greater than 14 and less than 64. So it goes to left side. 13 is less than 14 but greater than 31. So it goes to this side. And 110 is greater than 14, greater than 64 and it will be occupied this place. So let's calculate the balance factors as well. So we can update the balance factor. Our balance factor now will be, we can actually make one more insertion, 98. 98 is greater than 14, 64, but less than this. So this way, this is occupying this place. So balance factor of 98 is 0, balance factor of 1110 is 1, 64 is minus 1, balance factor of 26 is 0 and 13's balance factor is again 0, 1's balance factor is minus 1 and 14's balance factor is minus 1. So as if now our tree is balanced and we need not to perform rotations. Then we have to insert 85. So when we are inserting 85, 85 is greater than 14, greater than 64, but less than 1110. So it goes to 98. It is also smaller than 98. So it goes to left side. So now we will recalculate the balance factor. Now balance factor of 85 is 0. So the balance factor of 85 is 0, 98 is 1 and 1110 become 2 and 64 become minus 2, whereas 14 will become minus 2 and rest remains same. Okay? So it is now imbalanced and we have to perform rotations. So when we will perform left rotation only, it will sort our things. So let's perform the rotations. We will perform left rotation. We have to perform RL rotation. So we are performing right rotation first here, and then we are performing I guess this would work fine. So we are performing right rotation as if now. This will help us to balance our tree. So let's check out how. We have 14, 64 and 26. So when we are performing right rotation here, so it will become 98 here, 85 will remain same and this goes to downside. So we can check our balance factor now again. So with this balance factor of 85 is 0, 1110 is 0, this will again be 0, 64 will be 1 and 26 will be 0, and this will become minus 1. The rest remains same. Fine. So now you can check, this is our AVL tree, and the all the nodes have been occupied. So we are lastly performing only the right rotation. So we have performed right left rotation here, then we have performed right rotation here, and our result will be an AVL tree. So this way we can perform insertions and construct AVL tree. So in our next session we will be discussing the deletion operation in AVL tree, how we can delete an existing node from our AVL tree, and what effect can be there on the balance factor, and then how we perform rotations to make it again an AVL tree or a balanced tree. Fine. So any doubt as if now, please ask.